Cincinnati allergies one last blow before I came on to hang out with you for domain names. Hopefully this will be a mucus-free time together. Okay, well, we are here to talk about domain names. And, you know, I people that meet me casually in non-domain life, they kind of think, like, what's the big deal about domain names, dude? Aren't you bored with domain names? Just ran into somebody just Saturday, and it's kind of like, don't you do something with domain names? It's like, yeah, I you know, talk about domain names, develop domain names. It's like, I get it. Domain names, maybe you're watching this on Restream, hopefully you're here with me live, and you're like, what's the big deal about domain names? Like, domain names, they just sit there and they're boring, and, you know, I have a big list of nearly 1,000 different domain names, and they just sit there. I couldn't even name them unless I go look at the list. That's how boring they are. Like, they're really not much. But what they can be, the potential, is the beautiful piece of a domain name. It's why people go on searches for great domain names all the time. They're always looking to add more potential to their life. But for those out there who have domain names, maybe just one even, and you're like, what's the big deal about domain names? Let me just say, it's about development. It's that potential. It's realizing the development. And if you're bored, then, well, then let's get them developed. So, okay, well, let's get things started. I see a mention of audio, and I will work on that just after we get started. Make sure you say hi in the chat. Let us know you're here. See you on the other side of this. From a name to profit, domain to profit, from a dot on to a business idea. Take a domain name, develop an income from domain to profit. We'll show you how. Domain to profit, from domain to profit. Join Drew Walsh and start it right now. Okay, hopefully this is a little bit better. I have no idea. I got little gizmos and gadgets aplenty. We'll figure it out and see how it works. And we'll see if the frame rate and all that stuff works as well. I don't know. Technology. I don't get it. Got the moving stuff back here. Maybe it'll work. Maybe it won't. Okay, either way, we are here. It is Domain to Profit. I am Drew Walsh. We are going to be looking through expiring domain names. Got a list in front of me here, 96,000 domain names that are over on GoDaddy Auctions expiring. We're going to be looking through the top ones coming up. So let me check in, see who all is here with me hanging out. I appreciate you all. Mike, see you coming in first. Like good old days, I appreciate it. Here for show, what, 116? 116 episodes, and Mike has been first, I think, for the most of them. So nice to have you here. Bill, nice to have you as well. And Hugh, nice to see us. Hello, everybody. Indeed, I appreciate you all. It's always a good time. And yes, there was an echo. Hopefully I got rid of that a little bit, Matt. Kind of let me know. Oh, my goodness. Need to run through all these. Lots of them real quick. Pixelworks. That's kind of fun, too. But Pixelworks, nice to see you here, Ian, as well, and Domain Explorer with your Domain Explorer tools. I appreciate you. Stuart, nice to see you as well, and Hugh, and from India here, 1230. That's okay. Well, nice to have you here. Thanks for joining us. Hopefully the energy I'm able to bring can keep you up for just a little bit longer, or not. It's okay. And yes, good. I'm glad to see that. Glad to see that it is fixed. I had a setting in my audio stuff that somehow got screwed up. So, and yeah, isn't it crazy? Like every single day, there's so many domain names dropped, most of which we don't even look at. Like we won't look at so many domain names today. We skip through so many of them here on the show, and just think each one of these domain names that we look at. Somebody registered them. Somebody thought, hey, this would be a good domain name. This means something to me. I have a dream tied to this domain name, and they pay the $10, and that $10 got them a domain name, and that domain name gave them a chance. And it wasn't a good enough domain name to give them like everything, right? Like it takes a great domain name to have a great chance. And that's what we talk about here. We don't just talk about, you know, any domain name. In fact, let's go over to the whiteboard, this right here. We talk about this here. This is the gray box that you see over here. In fact, let me go to a different one. Boom, right here. Okay. So this gray box that we have here is the domain name. And just think of it as that real estate. I registered. I'm going to build something grand on it. That's going to be this business right up here. You can build anything your heart can come up with on a domain name, anything at all. Peter Askew, he posted like his homepage is just full of a bunch of old GIFs and stuff, which I love. I geek out over it. You can put anything you want to on your domain name. Then you can buy a domain name and sell it. And, you know, that's great. But realistically, the domain names that we're looking for are great domain names. It's not good enough to just have a domain name. Yes, a domain name gives you a chance, but a great domain name gives you a great chance. And that's exactly what we're looking for with this gray box here. A great domain name is going to give you authority. What does authority mean? It means when you talk to people in the industry that domain name represents, they assume that you already know something about that industry, even if you don't. I don't know anything about towing, and as the guy that owns towing.com and has ran it and made millions of dollars building that site and sharing it with towing companies, I will tell you, I don't really know anything about towing, but the domain name gives me that authority, and it gives me the validation necessary to come into an industry, and people go, hey, you know, we don't really know much about you, but, you know, you have the ticket. You have that golden ticket, that domain name that allows you to speak. And it's a seat at the table. It's validation. And then that, speaking of seat at the table, it's access to an industry. So you don't know if you need or want to know, but you know, I have towing.com, bartenders.com, djs.com, discjockey.com, photobooths.com. So many great domain names that represent the dreams of lots of small businesses that we are developing to share with those small businesses. It's a big deal. We want to give so that's what we're looking for. We're not just looking for a domain name. We're looking for great domain names, and that runs in different levels. There's great, and there can be great and specific and great and not. But realistically, as we look to this list, you will see a lot of domain names that are not great. Not great. They may be considered valuable. In fact, what we did is we did hitting buttons like crazy over here. Down here, you will see the URL where you can watch a video. It shows you the filters that we set up to produce this list over on expireddomains.net. Expireddomains.net. It's free. Not a sponsor. We just love them and appreciate the tool that they've created for us and support them. So, but what we've done is we've gotten rid of all the hyphens, all the numbers. We only look at 1 to 3 English words at domain names only.com, which I have .com right on the bottom of my mug, written in Sharpie. Sharpie, not dry erase marker. It's there, hopefully, for a long time. And each of these domain names we're going to see on this list, most of which we're going to skip over. Somebody went out there and registered. Some of them are considered valuable. But even if they're considered valuable, the question is it valuable to you? Can you build on it? Can you have a great opportunity and have great success with this domain name? Well, we'll find out. We're going to look these domain names together and find hopefully next opportunity, possibly something I might even pursue as an opportunity as well. Because yes, I do look at these domain names and I'll buy them as well. I'll let you know often even if I'm going to participate in what I'm going to participate at. Just checking out chat right here. Just looking Atul. Hopefully I got that right. Atul is asking about closeouts, which closeouts are, as I understand them, that is when a domain name nobody bids at all, that domain name goes to closeout. You can buy it. It starts at, I believe, $50 and then counts down from there. I buy them at closeout. In fact, I used to never bother with it. I would just bid on them at auction. But nowadays, especially if it's an in-between domain name, I'll let it go to close out and purchase. But it's definitely not my focus. So I usually, if I want a domain name and I'm going to go after something, I'm going to go after it with everything I have. So, and let me go and grab this one question here. One of the tools that we do use here, which Domain Explorer is asking about, is SpyFu. And he's asking, or they are asking, is SpyFu more accurate than Google AdWords in terms of stats? And the answer to that, I will tell you, is yes. Here is SpyFu. This is the tool that we will use. And we will talk about how Google data is used to generate the data you see here on SpyFu. And we'll see how the data is better on SpyFu, in my opinion, for the purpose of what we're doing here. So, okay, well, let's get going. So what we're going to do is spend time just going right down the list. If you see a domain name that you love or that you want us to talk about, feel free to yell it out, well, or type it out into the live chat. If you're not watching live, you're welcome to add it in afterwards. As you will know, all these domain names are going to be expiring this week. So if you're watching it on Restream, you might have missed or probably have missed out on some of the domain names you see here. But the lessons and things we talk about, hopefully they carry forward regardless of the domain name. So we have 96,000 domains that you can see up there. And here we go. So I've taken the list and I'm going to order it by valuation. The valuation is not the actual value of the domain name. The valuation is, as I say each week, think of it as an order code or what belongs on top of this list. We have 96,000 domains, or now it's down to 94,000 domains. The question is which one should we show on top of the list? Well, valuation makes an estimate of which one's more valuable than others and brings some to the top. So that brings advancedsystems.com to the top. Tends to be a little bit generic, not a huge fan of it. Like, I like generic, but sometimes they're too generic. Advanced systems, we're talking advanced defense systems, advanced driving systems, who knows? So certainly a reasonable domain name. I see over here that it is a setup for, it's currently $2,600, so I'm going to pass on that one. Deluxe homes, I don't mind too terribly much. Let's click on deluxe homes. This might be our first domain name that we're going to jump over to SpyFu on. So deluxe homes, 6 days left, $1,608 is the current bid on this domain name. So now what I'm doing is I pasted the domain name without the .com, and you're going to go and paste in and add a space. So it took the domain name and now you just turn in the keywords. So it's an exact match keyword domain name. So that's it, deluxehomes.com. Let's see if people are actually searching for deluxe homes. So here you go. You can see indeed some are looking for people are searching for deluxe homes. How many? There are 110 monthly searches for deluxe homes as a keyword. And so the question earlier by Domain Explorer of whether the Google AdSense data was, or AdWords was more accurate than SpyFu, it's actually the same data. But what's doing here, if you kind of hover it, it does show up. You won't be able to read where it's pretty small on your screen. But it's saying that it's looking at that Google data, and then it's considering whether or not that data is like how much of that data is going to actually be available to you. So if you're going to target this keyword, they say that there's 110 searches available for you. Now, if you scroll down, you'll actually get the Google provided data. So this is the data that Google is providing. And what we typically see here is the search volume is usually much higher. So Google usually has a very high number for the search volume. And then SpyFu, weeds it down to a smaller number because local search and maps and everything take up most of those clicks, most of the potential searches. In this case, that's not the case. They're actually estimating more, which not sure how that happens, but so be it. So advertisers. There's only one advertiser for this keyword. In Deluxe, I believe with an E is kind of a, I don't know if with an E, it's a little fancy spelling. I don't think it's necessarily required. Maybe it is. Maybe it is. But we don't see many advertisers. We only see one, meaning there's not really competition to target this keyword. And then we see the cost per click is zero. So as far as the domain names we're looking for, when we go to this idea over here of, or over here, where we're talking about authority, validation, access to an industry, and we're looking for that under the ground type stuff that we can just tap into. We just want to tap this domain name and pull out some of that value. There's really not much happening here. Who are we going to pull value from? That one person, the one person that's getting traffic potentially by paying as minimal amount as possible? Most likely not. Therefore, this domain name, we're going to skip over and just continue talking about. Sound is getting funny again. Keep me posted on that. I'm sorry if there is audio issues. I don't necessarily see them, but keep me posted. And Matt, you can run down here or something if you need to. But okay. Keeping moving on down the list. Best drone. If you're into drones or something like that, could be something that you would dive into. Squill. I like Veranda, but one of the things about verandas.com is it is an enom domain name. You'll see that right up there. Enom is the domain name. It is essentially enom is a registrar, and you'll find that in often cases their domain names are they don't make it all the way through auction. In fact, I think we marked a couple last week and none of them made it to auction. So we don't talk about them because, well, you're not going to have a chance to buy it. So why should we talk about it? But hey, add it to your watch list. And if you get a chance to buy it, then go for it. Aerial Vision, Fast Floor. Mad News. So you'll see like that valuation that we had over on the side. Well, over here in this column. If I can get it to show up. There we go. This column over here is that valuation number. And you'll see we're skipping over quite a few of these domain names. They're just not worth really talking about. So the idea that they're worth $5,000-$6,000, as you might be able to guess, just very unlikely. Certainly not to me. Domain in. So here's a question. Thank you for the questions. Keep them in. General is asking, if you lose a domain name auction, do you get your money back? There's yes, actually. Like if you're not the top bidder, you do not pay. There's different formats for auctions. GoDaddy is one where once you've signed up, once you have went through their process of verifying and validating you as a bidder, you like as long as you win, you win. And if you win, you do have to pay. Like, I don't think there's an exit other than getting booted out of town. You'll definitely have your account blackballed if you do not pay. So certainly pay if you win. But if you're like second or third, yeah, you don't pay anything for that. There are other domain name auction services. There's like namejet.com or snapname.com. They have different domains altogether. To participate, you have to be willing to add the domain name to your cart and say, I am willing to pay $69 or $79 for this domain name. And the only way you even join the auction is by being willing to pay that money, but you only pay the money if you actually win the domain name. So you don't pay for pay unless you win. Auction responsibly. Bird seeds. I usually like plural domain names. That one I'm going to be a skip on. Near bank. See, these are like somebody out there registered these. They had a hope. They had a dream. They thought they'd do something with them, and they're not. Now the question is who's going to pick up it? App. I don't really like I own a few domain names with app in them. Not a big fan, but this, I'm sure there's something out there. Although our dishwasher at our house recently broke, and we're going through the difficulty of adding getting a new dishwasher. So in regards to the kitchen app, the question is, do you need a dishwasher with Wi-Fi? I mean, no. Like, what in the world? Anyhow, drives me nuts the stuff they're putting on these. I don't need a kitchen app. I think it's overkill to even have a fridge where you can, like, see the camera that goes inside. That, like, why? Just keep my food cold. Clean my dishes. Okay, I saw another domain name thing. I did move the microphone out. Hopefully that does the trick. You think 116 weeks in, I would have it cleared. But I continue to have issues, so. Aye, aye, aye. But I keep working on it. Leeds Genie. Like, if it was Lead Genie, I'd like that. That's one of those middle S's, right? So one of the things I warn about is do not, if it has a middle S, you really need to understand it's most likely not a good domain. Leadsgenie.com, I would pay money for that. Leeds Genie, even if leads are typically plural. So typically you don't buy a lead, you buy leads. But Leeds Genie, the middle S gets stuck in there, and you're actually going to get the domain name leadsgenie.com. You're going to get leadsgenie.com. That's leads with an S in the middle, genie.com. Like you're going to always have to specify that S is there. So, full of static for the audio issue. I hope it's not as bad as what, I'm full of snot. Anyhow. See much of my levels. I do see some stuff. Somebody asked how many domain names I have. I have just under 1,000 domain names. I was up over 1,000 domain names, but then I started to let the domain names expire to concentrate on high quality domain names. Which I still have a lot of garbage domain names. Some I keep around just because they've taught me a lesson, which you've seen them in weeks past. I think just last week I showed some of the first domain names I've purchased, and one of which I think was Cabinet Manufacturer. And I own that domain name, and it's just like, it's garbage. And what's another one? Insurance Agent Broker. I think insurance, like I have a couple of them, and it's like they're almost good enough to register, but almost they are the lessons that what taught me that almost is not good enough. Those are the domain names I keep. I think in one case, Insurance Agent Broker or whatever, I paid like $600 for it. What in the world? That was, kick myself for that one. PlaySpin. Okay, let's get moving. Let's see some domain names here. I appreciate all the comment. Appreciate everything coming in. Hugh and Only an Acre, Domain Explorer, thank you for all the comments and keep me posted. Only an Acre is mentioning they have 30 domains. Like, I think you can get by with one. Like, you don't have to own a lot of domain names. It does become addicting. And what a lot of times I think we end up doing is we get one with the intent to, and this is probably you. So I'll Drew rant on this just for one moment. Chances are you're here because you bought one domain name at some point in the past and you were like, I'm going to make something amazing on this domain name. I have this business idea. And you start going down the path of creating that business and you're like, oof, this is a lot of hard work. I'm spending all my time learning. I don't really have anything out there to show yet, or maybe even get a site out there. And you get to the point that you have to actually do the work to make the money or make the calls. And it just is like, ooh, look, another domain name, another project, another business idea, and you move on. I think the idea of taking one domain name and developing it and doing the work to develop it, to bring value before you ever step away to go to something new, I think it's a good thing to do. So having only 30 or having only one is not a bad thing. Call center job. I would much prefer plural. So publishing solutions. I mean, these are good domain names. I could talk about them, but I'm going to keep pushing forward. Ace of Air. Office login. I guarantee that office login gets a lot of searches. The only thing is you're playing with trademarks, because office login, it's people with Microsoft Office 365 or whatever. Anyhow. Edward, nice to see you popping in. Nice to have you. Let us know any good domain names you see on the list. That goes for everybody. Set up those filters and jump ahead even. Cosmoses. Bridal events. Okay, we're going to dive into this one a little bit. What was that? I think it was just a few weeks ago. Oh, okay. Well, we haven't seen this in a few weeks, actually. So here you go. Just clicked on, bridalevents.com. And it says this domain name is no longer available. This is the price we pay here, folks. Essentially, these are expiring domain names, and an expiring domain name can be renewed by the old owner, so it can be very late into the domain name. This is why we don't talk about enum domains, actually. Look at that. That's actually funny that it's an enum domain. So I usually say, if you can see this over on the far side, I don't think you can actually. I say that a lot of times those enum domains get pulled back about 2 days left into the auction. And bridal events, that's exactly what happened. I was excited about it for a brief moment. I was going to mention that I believe I purchased weddingconference.com a few weeks ago. We talked about it right here on the show. I ended up getting it, paid $100 or so more than what I wanted to, but that's just kind of life. I wish I could turn off, maybe I'll contact expired domains, see if I could turn off enum domains. Only shirts, these are all enum, all the reasonable ones are showing up as enum. So the reason we don't talk about them is because they end up getting renewed last minute. And if we talk about them, all we're doing is like giving free publicity and free talking to the person that owns it. And why do that? I'm here to help you find a domain name you can actually buy, that you can actually develop, not just point you in the direction of somebody else's domain name. Expert construction, Ripple project, escort booking, Ford Escort, maybe. Keep remedy shop, hemp root, smartphone covers, another enum. Although I don't like that. Like, that's a pretty long domain name. And let's see here, moving on still. So all of these domain names, we're looking through GoDaddy expiring domain names. These are domain names that are going to be expiring over the course of the next week. So they're not going to be here next week. Like, these are this is your one opportunity. Every domain name we see on this list, this is your one opportunity to get it, is over the course of this week. Well, either that or you can pay a bunch of money to the person that does get it. That happens all the time. Okay, not a whole lot of domain names. Vision leadership. Yeah. IT lessons. I don't know. What do you think? Let's go check it out. We've not had too many off that first list. Okay, so itlessons.com is what we're looking at. 5 days left, and we see it is a $12 bid currently. And if it's $12, even if it's not, what do we say? Make sure not to bid. Do not bid on this domain name. We are wanting to wait until just over 5 minutes left, 5 minutes, 20 seconds left. That's when you want to bid. Otherwise, what you're going to do is, if you love this domain name or you love any other domain name that is out there, well, you're going to draw attention from people. And speaking to what I think Atul was asking earlier, do I ever mess with the closeout? Well, if you do not bid and no one bids on this domain name and it stays $12 and no one ever bids, countdown goes to zero. What would happen as of that point is it would go to a closeout. As of that point, the price goes from $12 to $50, but the first person to buy it wins. So kind of an option for you is, if you don't want to draw attention to it at an auction to where the price can go for hundreds, you can let it expire and try to be the first person that gets it at closeout for 50. That's a game you can play, you know, but yeah, there you go. So you can try to wait to the last second and bid or bid. So itlessons.com, hey, 210 people searching for the keyword IT lessons. That kind of sounds kind of interesting. I like seeing that. So what I just did now was I did a control F on my browser. I pasted in IT lessons and I did a, so this will highlight all the places IT lessons shows up on the screen. And as I kind of was expecting, it's not used. So a lot of times what we will see is a good keyword will appear, or a good keyword set will appear in numerous places around the screen. So to show, yes, 210, but then there'll also be other longer tail keywords that use that that phrase. And we're not seeing that here. Meaning, this, think of this as this keyword, IT lessons or IT lessons, whatever it's happening here, .com, it's on an island all by itself. It's not part of an industry. It's not part of a larger community. What are you actually getting access to? What are you actually getting authority from? Probably not much. That's what we're kind of looking for when we're looking at this. So you do have 210 searches for it. That's okay. But then what we, when we scroll down here, while we may not use the search volume, we do want to look at the cost per click, which right now there's zero. Nobody's paying to reach the traffic related to IT lessons. So zero. And then the advertisers are zero. So since we've not seen it yet, I'll just say advertisers, I like to see double digits. I want to see 9, 10, or I've seen 22. I think we've seen 20 some advertisers before. I want to see that. I want to see people like fighting tooth and nail, just in there with claws, trying to win the traffic for the keyword we're looking at. And right now there's zero. So keep that in mind. And they're paying zero. So I want to see cost per click, $2 or higher. That shows that they're paying good money and there's a lot of them. That is where the good zone happens at. Edward Austin out some keyword things. Appreciate it. Look at that. He's sharing it out. That means he's probably not going to bid on those ones. Phone labs, advanced systems. Yeah, we saw that one up on top. Mostly brandables. Yeah. Brandables. That's kind of what I saw. We haven't made it to the bottom of the first list this quickly in quite some time. So, hey, look at this. Executivedesks.com. Sales job board. Sales job board. I typically don't like that middle S, but I don't think it would make sense to say sale job board. Sales job board. Let's check it out. Need like music that every time I click on a link, it's like do. I was working on it, but I don't have it. And to be quite honest, until I get the audio stuff figured out, I don't really want to go toss in extra stuff, but I love the audio. That's why we have a theme song. I've had that since week one. Like, hey, I need a theme song. Actually, week two or three. Okay. Sales job board, 110 searches are happening for it. So here's what I want to do with this domain name. I want to do that control F, paste that in here, space out the words. So this, I just did what we just talked about. I did a control F, paste it in the keywords, and you'll see sales job board free. So there are other places, other ways that this keyword phrase is being used. It's not just being used for our specific keyword for this 110 searches. It's also being used for these other ones. And you'll see in most cases, boards, sales job boards with an S is much more common. So there's a little bit of traffic here. Nothing really all that spectacular. But this is what we want to look at this. This is it. This is it. This is what we're looking for. When we talk about authority and this over here is that this over here is that Google data, and you'll see seven advertisers. So we're not quite to double digits, but seven advertisers paying, it says $31 per click. So that's way over $2. So here's how this works into things. I finally get to talk about this. What that is saying or telling us is there's at least seven companies out there and they're competing based on price. So this is, so even though there are 110, you know, it's only 110 volume, this keyword's valuable to those seven companies. Now, the reason why that matters is if you're interested in sales, if you're interested in running a jobs board, you want to know that you could get those first users to your site or the first paying customers, right? Because the day one, once you buy this domain name, which is currently $12, so don't bid on it yet. This one's going to end just after the show next week. So we'll skip over it next week, but just so you know, it's going to be there. This domain name is going to cost you some amount of money once to just to buy the domain name. And then once you do that, you're going to have some version of development costs, even if you keep it as simple as possible, do it in-house, whatever it is, whether you use WordPress or some other template, up to you, but there's going to be costs associated with it. You're going to need to make your money back. You're not in business for the fun of it. You're in business because you want to be able to generate revenue and bring value to the world through your domain name. And those numbers down at the bottom where we see the number of advertisers and the cost per, that shows us, think of it as a gauge of how easily can you get that for a customer? If those numbers are high, that means there's blood in the water and people are scrapping to get an advantage to target sales job. They want something to do with this topic. So now, when you call up the advertisers on the web or start to develop and share, everybody like, hey, I'm developing sales job board, and it's going to be specifying sales jobs, both high and low end, and so on and so forth. And you start to talk about it. Now that traffic, people are going to, like, there's blood in the water. They're going to be looking for you. They're going to want to, be on your site, at least in so much. Look at that. They're fortunate to reach the keyword. So that's the kind of thing that we're looking for here. The thing is, the volume are pretty low. So yeah, I think the domain name, based on the cost, I usually can to come up with a value, just a rough estimate. A lot of times you can take like the cost per click, the cost per click amount, weigh it against the number of advertisers. In this case, there's less than 10. So that's probably, I would weigh it about a $13 per click. So $13 per times 100, you can maybe get away with $1,300 for this domain name. That's that lower end of the development range. If you're all in on this domain name, you can go up to $1,300. If this is going to be some side hustle project, I wouldn't go that high. I'd try to keep it at $300 or less. If you can get it for $12, then that's awesome. That is awesome. Okay, catching up on chat a little bit here. Okay, might be a short one. When I move certain ways, it breaks up. Huh, okay. Well, I gotta move. Could be weird because I'm stuffed up. I don't know if it shows up, but I'm stuffed stuffed up today. I'm just hoping for a mucus-free show. We'll see. I can't make any promises. I do like sales job board. I'm not the sales job, or I'm not the jobs board person or job board person, but certainly I know there's some of you out there in this community that develop jobs boards. So certainly a pretty good one to keep an eye out. Again, don't bid on it yet. It's not ready for the bids. Oh, your smile matters. Your smile matters, folks. Okay. Moving on. Superplasma. So you read these and you see like loud kids. That's funny. You see all the domain names that are here, whether they're registered by somebody who planned on developing it and just never did, or whether it was registered by a diverson, like, you know, somebody else's dream ends and you have the opportunity to pick it up. Tickets Theater. We all know the person that owns theatertickets.com. At least I do. He works over at GoDaddy. Good guy, actually. Seasalts.com or Sicilian Seasalt. Anyhow. Let's see here. Come on, give us a good domain name. We are looking for a tourism job. Is that a thing? Does that sound like an actual thing? I don't. Tourism job sounds. Tourism job. I think that might actually be what people would search for. Ends in 2 days, $12 currently. So this is another example of do not bid on this domain name yet. Let's see if tourism job gets any searches. 44 searches. Let's do the control F as well to see if it shows up elsewhere, because I think it might. Yes, it does. Okay, this one's a pretty good one to use. The control F is why we do it. 44 searches for tourism job. When we do the control, we see here in the middle, if I can get it, my big old head out of the way, hospitality and tourism jobs, so jobs plural, 1,500 searches. So, hey, this our exact match is pretty low, but 1,500, now you can go after that bigger keyword because you have a piece of the keyword. So 1,500 people are searching for hospitality and tourism jobs. You can have hospitality jobs, tourism jobs on tourismjob.com. Makes sense. I also love to see this, as you likely know. I like it when my keyword, when my domain name shows up followed by near me. That means people are looking for this keyword around them. They're interested in this topic near me, meaning we can develop the site. It tells us how to develop it. That's what we love to have, is a domain name that tells us what needs to be on it. It's paint by number, color by number. There's a canvas there. The lines are all drawn with numbers. And now you just do what it says. And this is telling you that if you got tourismjobs.com, you should have a local search so people can find jobs near them. That's exactly what that keyword's saying. 900 times people are searching for it. The plural's getting searched 840, and you'll see that it kind of keeps going. We see our keyword popping up in there. So there you go. That's, I like to have that. So this third column over here, right behind me, is the keywords. Those are the questions people are asking the search engine. So they're asking Google, they're like, hey, what are the highest paying seasonal tourism jobs? That sounds like a good question. You know where the answer for that should be? That should be on tourismjob.com, right? Like that's it. You don't even need to answer it. You just need to create a way for your visitors to come in and answer it. Like you can create a, whether it's a forum or a blog post with comments, be like, hey, where the, you know, here's 2022's summer tourism highest paying jobs. You ask that, where are they? And then people can post or whatever, or you can charge for people to post under that. Voila. What, just scrap together ways to make money. Now, here's the one downside that I'm seeing about this is advertisers, we have zero. Cost per click is 76 cents. So we're not seeing the money. We're not seeing the money already behind this domain name. And is that a big deal? Yes, that's a big deal. So I don't know how to value this domain name. I would probably, I think it's, to me, probably worth a few hundred bucks if I was to go deeper into this domain name and look deeper at the domain. I would click on these other keywords, see if people are paying for those, and do a little more research. For me personally, I will spend a couple hundred dollars on a domain name that I think is close enough to being good enough. I get that that's not everybody. It shouldn't be everybody. Don't waste your money. I can rely on my experience to spend a few hundred dollars, which I may on this one or may not. So I'm going to add it to my watch list and we'll see. Maybe it'll get a purchase. Maybe it won't. And as always, let me just add this disclaimer, because I want these developed. I'm not going to be the person to likely wholeheartedly dive into developing tourism job. So if that's you, make sure you tweet at me. Let me know that that is a domain name that you love and that you're going to go after, because I don't get in the way of a development. The purpose of the show is to have more domain names. And, I can pass on it. Now, you may start to bid a little. I'm not going to hand away a domain name to somebody. You know, I only trust people in the domain names industry so far. But anyhow, but reach out. We can chat about it. In most cases, especially if you're here pretty frequently commenting, and I know you're here, I will get completely out of the way, especially if it's not a domain name that is perfect for existing business model. So let me see here. A couple questions that we'll hit real quick. Mike's asking, Drew, when building sites, do you suggest a specific theme for specific niches? No, I honestly don't 100% know what you're at. I rather than theme, I say figure out how you can bring value. Like, look for value. What are people looking for? One of the most popular websites on the internet is Craigslist, and it's a hideous website, horrible to necessarily use, but it still gets a lot of traffic because it brings value to people. Like, it's simple and easy, and just remember that when you're kind of like, I need bigger, better, amazing themes. No, what you need is a site that brings value to your visitors. What are they looking for? And give it to them as easily as possible. So so in that answer, I'm thinking of themes more as the design of a website. We just got very basic design. Most people see our sites and they go, you guys put money with your sites? Like, your sites are lame. And it's like, that's okay. So like I bet you Craigslist, they just sit around and spend money and go, oh, you think we're lame? Well, so like you build a website that makes a bunch of money and then you can maybe correct somebody. But in most cases, great design is not, I love great design, but most important is customer experience, user experience. And you'll find with user experience, the main thing is giving them what they want. I honestly hate most of the present designs. I think it puts useful content way too far. The idea of having to scroll, it used to be the enemy of web design. And nowadays you have to scroll on everything. Things feel backwards to me as a designer. So maybe I'm not the best person to ask about design is what it comes down to. Okay, let me see here. Let me grab these other questions real quick. Is it interesting to own a domain name and redirect the SATO for domain DNS? I'm not entirely sure what you're asking there. Interesting. I don't think I have any domain names that go to SATO anymore. I used to use them for some domain if I was selling them. Don't just put them all on Epic currently. I look to buy domains to develop them. I don't really, very seldom, every once in a while here, you'll see me put it on my my investor hat and I'll buy a domain name because I think it's undervalued and I'll buy it probably to resell it, but you're talking 1 in 100 domains or 1 in 20 domains. Yeah, I agree, Stuart. All the cookie pop-ups and stuff. If you want to accept cookies, the web engine will get me started. You'll get me started on how much I hate big business and in the big government. Like, it makes the world worse. And it's like, okay, let's get back to where we're actually doing great things. And appreciate it, Mike. Yeah, we've done a lot of work on Tony.com and a lot of improvement. It's good. And no problem, you know. Thank you for asking. Hopefully I brought some value to you with your data question. So fluttering my mic. Well, we'll see what happens. I'm sorry. I often got some mic issues, it seems. Okay, let's go back to some domain names. Okay, so a few minutes left here. Hopefully the audio holds out. I hate that it's having any issues whatsoever. I don't know what to necessarily do about it. I don't understand why it's such a pain in the booty. Good vibes yoga. Good vibes, bro. I got nothing. Okay, come on. Let's get at least one more good domain name. I don't think I've purchased any domain names, but we can go check GoDaddy here shortly. Yeah, I changed the gain on my mic. Maybe that... it might have changed it. It might have been too low and was catching. Anyhow, modern applications, performance physique, hit pack, my deers. I actually like that. My deers, tree bio. Okay, some of these fall in brandables. Brandables being domain names that you can build a brand on. So when we look at this here, our domain name being that gray box, there's really not a whole lot under the ground. There's not a lot under the ground where it's authority validation. It's just flat land. Brandables are the flat land that you can build your enterprise on. That's what we look to do. So content pack, $12. Content pack, what would you build on it? I see this as video images. Packaged together. Maybe you sell content. I'm not sure. Let's see. Content pack actually gets 190 searches. Content packs for Sims seem to be a thing. No advertisers, no cost per click. So again, I'll put it under brandable. General is asking if I buy them every day. No, actually, I actually literally had to look through domains every day. Rhythm that find good ones, very much using the filters that we use here on the show. And they would go through them, highlight the ones that they think I should see. And every day I would review lists. But nowadays I don't have, like I said, close to domains. And I come here on this show each say, we develop domain names, and I truly wholeheartedly believe that. I try not to buy actively. I don't want to miss opportunities, but I am not out there in the trenches every day buying domains, because we are working on some pretty big things to develop domain names. So I do this show. In regards to developing domain names, but we also we're developing a web app that will allow us to develop our domain names. But then we also hope to package that up and allow you or others to develop their domain names with it as well. Not just develop them, but to place a business model on that domain name. Development's kind of easy. Like if you want to put something up on a website, there's lots of ways to do it. But if you want to put something on a website that can allow you to bring value and generate revenue, that's a completely different story. Like that's not something that's common, but we are working to develop it. So in fact, we're working to develop it. It's literally going to be called developit.com. So there you go. We'll review real quick these domain names that we have looked at. We have looked at Deluxe with an E. Wasn't all the price currently, but deluxehomes.com we looked at. ITlessons.com. Step to the side here. ITlessons.com. Reasonable name. Low price. Don't bid on it yet. But it could. The keyword data look great on it. Sales Jobs Board, probably that's one we had all day. $12 currently. Do not bid on it. Let's see if anybody broke the rules. Okay, good. Good. A plus, team. A plus. Don't bid on it till last minute. That one will end just after the show next week. So hopefully somebody out there gets it. TourismJob.com. I like this one more than Sales Job Board. And I believe I added it. Or at least I thought I added it to my watch list. There we go. Content Pack was just that last one that we had. So that's a summary. Let's go see. I don't think I purchased any domain names, but I will go give a live look to see. One. New view. I don't want to see the new view. I want to see the old view. Show me the old view. The old view is what we want to see. Okay, here we go. The most recent domain names I've purchased. So yeah, we already saw these last week. So somebody was asking about whether I do closeout domain storageflip.com and I believe towing storage. I believe I purchased both of those on, if you can see those back there, they're really small as of this point. I purchased both those on closeout. So some of these I've just been testing some different stuff. So yes. Yes. Beautiful voice indeed. I'm going to go on American Idol. No, I'm not. Okay. Well, I greatly appreciate all the great questions and community. Like this is for me to hang out with others like you. You know, realistically dealing with domain names, looking at lists, what we do is a very lonely job, right? This is like sitting around looking to domain names all the time. It's freaking you and a laptop. I did it for so many years by myself. And until I found the domain name community, I thought I was like the only one doing this stuff. And it turns out there's a lot of us. And it's just nice to be able to come together, look through domain names together and talk about them, share this little piece of nerdiness that we share, and also talk about the hope and the potential of domain names to give us the lives that we want. So thanks for joining me. Thanks for sharing the nerdiness and the passion and hope that I have with domain names. I do greatly appreciate it. Let's see. I did not mention liking and subscribing. Hopefully you've done that. It's YouTube. You should do that stuff. But especially here, if you're still watching, like and subscribe. I greatly appreciate it. But more than that, I just appreciate the comments, the questions, and hanging out with me in my nerdiness. So with all that said, I am Drew Wash. This is Domain to Profit. I will see you back here next week, 3 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, for us to go through some more domain names. See you then.